Bing bong bong ba dong ba dong. We ready to go?
Yeah, if you stop making weird noises.
Bing ding dong ba dong ba dong. Patrick, $100. Can you name this song? For $100, dog.
I know, and don't do this to me because you know I'm bad at music in general, and I'm also poor.
I'll give you a second.
This is not fair.
Give you a second. All right, this is the Brian Moote Show.
E40.
No. I said I'll give you a second. Settle down. You're jumping the gun here. No shazamming. Shireen's out today. She's sick with her kids. With her stupid, snivelly. Actually, I shouldn't say stupid, snivelly kids.
This is hot fire. Just coming in. We're
gonna hit the siren on me
with their little monster spawn.
No. Shireen's kids are lovely. They're wonderful kids. Luke and Maya. They're great. The thing is, like, the only experience I've ever had with them, Maya was being a real pill. And that on a morning radio show, I said that Shireen's kids were monsters. And she's like, thanks for that. My husband, Kenny's so pissed. You just called my kids monsters. I'm like, well, they're being monsters. She's like, well, Maya was just being me. Like, I'm like, all right, well, that's how my kids are going to be.
Maya was being a monster.
Right. So, I mean, if I've already accepted the fact that my girlfriend Jessica and I are going to have girls for sure, we're cursed. We're going to have girls. And I'm calling it a curse right now. And someday they're going to listen to this audio because I'm pretty sure my kids are going to go back and just want to archive and find out their father.
Yeah. That's what they're going
to
do.
Right. They're going to use their time to go back and listen to the shows they missed.
I can imagine that conversation with your kids where you're like, listen, kids, I know in your free time you're just Googling me and looking me up watching all my old work.
Look, when you guys Google me, you're never going to find...
School is important, too. You gotta
you're never going to find a different Brian Moote for like 9 pages on Google. Trust me, I've looked a million times. The Brian Moots are weak. I honestly, we will be cursed with girls because my girlfriend Jessica, her dad told me this. And also Jessica told me this. She was an a-hole when she was a girl, like a child. And this is how you know that your child's an a-hole. And if you were an a-hole, you can't even argue this. She got emancipated at 17 and just said, I'm out. And her parents are like, bye.
See ya, jerk.
All right, have a good one. So that's why she's cursed to have girls, because you can have a bunch of little hers. And I'm cursed to have girls because as a single dude in show business till I was in my mid-30s, like, I've got a hell of a lot of karma coming my way. Like, I have already accepted that fact. Like, it's just a landslide of karma. You don't think so?
No, not necessarily.
I mean, with all
you're a good dude.
Yeah, come but on. even a good dude single for 15 years has some, you have some karma. Even when you do the thing where you tell, you're honest and you say, like.
So you're just saying if you have a bunch of girls, they're going to be a bunch of sluts.
Yeah. Smoke shows who are complete jerks.
Oh, God.
Yeah, no. Oh, sorry, God. Uncle right. Pat.
Yeah, no, I don't have any kids.
All right, please hit up the studio burner. We got some good texts we're going to get to in this first segment. It's 310-429-8903. We have not gotten to the voicemails yet, but I need you to leave voicemails because you guys are the voice of the show. I'm very anti-radio currently and probably for the rest of my life in terms of like the hacky stuff people do. I don't want a catchphrase. I don't want anything cheesy. I don't need like the big voice guys like, hey, everybody, welcome to the Brian Moote Show or whatever. I want you guys to be that voice. I want you guys to call us in. By the way, when Bosworth makes an appearance, bark box.
Arf, 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 arf. We got a bark box appearance. All right.
Use the code Boz at bark box. That's not a real thing yet. We're trying to get it sponsored.
We're working on it.
By the way, when we're at Shady Center Studios, we will do our show all over the place. But Bosworth, Patrick's dog, will literally sleep the entire day, except as soon as we start doing a radio show, he's like, what's up, guys? Let me dig around, lick my feet, lick my junk.
He's like his dad. He's trying to be part of the show. He just wants to be involved.
Your dog, side note before we get into the other stuff, we're going to read text in a second, and I'll get back to what I was talking about. On your worst days of your life, hungover, sick, whatever, for Patrick, chemotherapy, it is your dog's Super Bowl. Your dog has never had a better day.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Like, that's what they're like, I've been waiting my whole life for this. You trying to binge watch all the Harry Potters? I'm right here with you, dog.
We did do that. We even made it to that the the other one, Fantastic Beasts. We made it deep. We went deep down that rabbit hole.
That's how you know that you're really...
You've gone too far.
Extra time on
My
your
roommate
hands.
Came in and he was like, what are you watching? I was like, I don't know anymore.
I don't know anymore. Johnny Depp's now in these things, man. When the hell did Johnny Depp get here? Are those the Fantastic Beasts? Side note. Is that a prequel, sequel? What is that?
Prequel.
Prequel. Does that mean before?
Yes. Brian, that's what
I asked you a question and I didn't even know what it meant when you told me the answer.
And honestly, there's evidence in the word that should lead you to believe that it's the prequel. I don't know why sequel.
I get it.
Speaking of prequels, I watched Prometheus today.
I don't know why you thought that'd be a really cool thing.
I don't know either.
You know what? That's bad radio.
Yeah, that's bad radio. I know.
That's the thing we're like, oh, that thing you just said reminds me of this thing.
Good.
But this has to be better than that. Otherwise, you're going nowhere.
Good point, Brian. Here's something unrelated.
Hey, you said the word pre, and I know something about pre.
Prometheus. That's a bad movie.
You ever drive a Prius? You floor it. It's like a golf cart, but it's bigger. But you save gas. And you save the earth. All right, we got a few seconds left in this opening segment. But we're going to get to the text here in a second that you guys hit us up with on the studio burner, which is 310-429-8903. And like I was saying... I want you guys to be the voice of the show. Everyone who listens to this, I want you to call in, leave a voicemail, whether it's just like a random ass question you want answered, or if you want to give us an intro to the show. It's the Brian Moote Show, and then rip on Pat. It's the Brian Moote Show. Pat drives a Prius. He doesn't, but that's still funny.
How about Pat and the legendary pecs?
Pecs. Pat and his pecs. And what did you call it? The baby cannon. No, it was the loin cannon. Groin cannon. Loin cannon. We all get it. So you guys need to be the voice of our show. I'm done with the corny big boss radio guy thunders in like a Sunday monster truck nonsense. No matter what form this show eventually takes, which, by the way, spoiler alert, talks are happening. We will always make you people who listen, you folks, you people who comment, who interact, who hit up the studio burner, which, by the way, is always on Patrick, and he will write back to you.
I will.
He will do that. He's got plenty of free time.
Sometimes it's, yeah. Well, you know, depends on what time of day. You might get back something interesting.
I guarantee you get back something interesting. All right, coming up next, we are going to hit up that studio burner.
You're listening to the Brian Moote Show. We are nothing but pecs, armed and loaded. Bunch of push-ups, push-up factories. I got to get more confident when I do my intros.
Push-up factories.
That's funny, right?
I mean,
if someone told you they're a push-up factory, you'd be like, oh, hell yeah, you are. All right, hit up the studio burner, 310-429-8903. I will replace that. I've decided today that I'm going to get a more convenient 1-800 number that you guys can all text. Or maybe I'll get a short text. You know, those short text things? We did not do a very good job up front on the show teasing what's on the show today, so I'm going to do that right now. We're going to talk about LeBron James being an extra Little League dad. Pat and I will also tell some stories about Little League dads. You know, a radio topic. Oh, let me hit my... I forgot. Hold on. It's a radio topic. Am I up? Am I here?
You're up.
It's a radio topic. It's a radio topic.
Later on in the show, boy, that LeBron James, people are criticizing him because he was a little bit extra on the sidelines of his son's AAU Summer League games. So we're going to talk about the times that parents have been crazy at Little League games. That's called a radio topic. What we're going to do later.
All right. We're also going to talk about, this is big, man. We missed this. The last two shows were idiots. Which, you know, that just kind of goes with,
it's fair. It's fine.
Goes with the territory.
I'm comfortable with it. I don't know where you're at on the spectrum comfortable with being an idiot, but I'm fine with it.
I'm okay with ranging from idiot to very confident blow torture of entertainment news to sometimes, man, we talk about social service stuff and I'm into it.
I'm not into any of that.
You just own your lane.
There are times you get it. Sometimes I'll see you on some sort of like social justice campaign on Twitter and I'll be like, Brian, please stop. You're making me uncomfortable.
It's been 3 months.
You're blowtorching. I hate blowtorch mode.
All right. It's been. You got to ease in on that, man. That's gonna make someone crash. You can't come firing in with that sound effect that hot.
People need to know that there's a threat.
That I have a blowtorch.
There's a threat.
You guys have all seen it. If you follow me on social media, and sometimes you just got to reply with Brian, blowtorch mode. We'll just fire emojis. Because I haven't been on blowtorch mode in a while. Sometimes my blowtorch mode, which I would also say is very self-aware. And I'll look back and say, I should delete some of those. But also, I'm honest, man. If I've taken down radio people who I believe are reckless with their platforms. And look, you may not like everything I say, but I'll be the first person if you ever have a problem. If you ever have something that you need in terms of the world, the social justice world, I'll be there for you. Like, look, I'm very consistent. You may not like it when I pull the flamethrower out and go at, some cause on Twitter, but at least I'm consistent. And it's also true. I know when to take it down because I know it's going to come back and bite me in the ass.
That's
called
fair.
Fear.
It's called fear. I have a healthy respect for fear.
It's called, look, man, I would leave those tweets up if I didn't have to pay my mom's car payment, but I do. So I got to take those things down. BarkBox, code Boz, please. BarkBox.com.
He's a good boy.
Yeah, but I just want to give him another
plug. Where's my good boy?
So we're going to talk about Patrick climbed a mountain for the colorectal cancer organization, which he is an ambassador for.
Splash. I don't know why that's my ambassador.
That's your catchphrase?
Splash.
That you climbed a mountain. How's Splash involved in that?
Crunch.
That makes no sense, but it's
funny. It does.
Whatever, as long as it's funny, we'll let it slide.
Stepping on rocks. Crunch, crunch, crunch.
All right, get the phone out. What's the burner? What's the burner up to? Let's get some burner text.
Oh, let's see. What do we got?
The burner number, 310-429-8903. Save that in your damn phones. Hit them up at all times. Drunk dial us. That's another thing. Please, leave us your drunkest messages, because that's never been done on the radio. It's a new, but no, what's never been done on the radio is
like, we should have people call when they're like sober.
No, we should have them call back when they're sober and listen to their drunk message and like sad drunk. I want sad drunk messages. Those are the best. You ever just get to a point where like you say something like, no one even cares anyway? I've said that a few times this past week.
All right.
What are the text messages from the burner phone? Text him any time of the day or night.
We're going to start with my favorite. Okay. Text.
Favorite text to the studio burner.
So my favorite text to the studio burner is from the 678.
What up, 678?
What up, 678? And it says, "Can we all agree that Pat is the hot brother?" Woo! Yes, we can.
In my current status, whatever, however you pronounce that, I would say, yeah, I'll agree with that. Pat is. He's Shred City right now.
Yeah, I'm shredded,
and,
dude.
And cancer did that to him, and he's all about the pecs.
I'm all about the pecs, baby.
Investigate his pecs.
Law and order.
Each pec.
That's what my pecs bring to the game.
Also, I'm a little on the fat side right now. I'm not proud of it. I'm not happy.
We're going to get you whipped right into shape.
Look,
there,
man.
Big boy.
Okay, big boy, you son of a... No, it's called depression. Kidding. But seriously, it's called emotional issues and depression. I go to a therapist. I'm just kidding. But kidding. You can tell on Twitter when I'm taking blowtorches and stuff. You think I'm happy when I'm doing that? Don't you siren me.
Running high!
Don't you siren me.
Get your cage!
Everybody run for cover. Brian's on Twitter and he's depressed and drunk. I would say unequivocally, Pat, you are the hot brother right now. And you got a good beard, man. You got blessed with the beard. We're not 100%. By the way, please, we do have some text questions we need you guys to weigh in on. There's some answers that we have coming up about my rap album, whether we need to release that or not. But also,
do
we need to? And because I'm all for it.
Let's see who's the hot brother then. Because if you have a hot fire single,
yeah,
Post Malone's hotter than me, and he's not like hotter than me. He's
I think I got a song called Alakazam.
Oof. Oof.
All right, hold on. Another question, though, I'd like you guys to weigh in on the studio burner, 310-429-8903, is this one. Pat and I have always speculated, we're not 100% brothers. Like, awesome. I mean, you got a beard. You're like wiry skinny. You're impossible. You'll never be fat in your life.
Mm-hmm.
You have like, you're like weirdly strong for how skinny you are.
Got these
like,
real dreamy eyes.
I mean, I got better eyes than you. Let's not get crazy.
Okay.
My eyes will run circles around your eyes.
Oh my God.
My dreamy blue
listen,
eyes.
Listen, no, if our eyes were in a, 100 meter sprint.
Oh, I'd mop the floor.
No, we would tie.
Mop the floor.
We would tie.
You're like weird hazel eyes. You
weird
and Kelly
hazel
Clarkson.
Eyes. They change color
behind
with
your
the
hazel
seasons.
Eyes. when I'm looking longingly at a lake with ducks on it
that's
and
right.
falling leaves in the autumn, they look like autumn leaves.
My eyes are like a mood ring. They get red when I'm happy.
What?
I don't know.
Oh my God, you really should have bailed on that whole analogy. All right. I got you in the eyes department, but you got me in the beard. You're wiry strong. I think you're like, you're normally heighted. How do you say that? I'm abnormally large.
Yeah,
where I look like I'm everybody's damn dad in a picture. It's obnoxious. Mm-hmm. I hate it. I have theories about why me and Top 40 Radio don't like jive all the time. And I think one of them is because I look like who invited the big white guy to the photo.
You are
like,
real.
Guys, come on in. Circle around. Let me tell you a story.
You do look like a guy who like stumbled into the back
right.
of the picture.
Like what nerd won a contest to be in a photo with Drake? That's me every single time. All right, so please weigh in. Do Pat and I need to get DNA tested at 23andMe? Because I'm a little worried mom fired off a little bit of dad in the early 80s. But just based on how you look, we have no other reason to think other than the fact that my parents didn't get along all the time. But that's a side note, neither here nor there.
What if we found out it was like, she was like, yeah, it's true. There was like, this really famous rich person was up here filming a movie.
That'd be amazing. It'd be like,
I'd be so upset with her for not telling me that before. I'd be
oh,
so
sooner?
Pissed at her.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that would be funny.
You're
actually related to a famous actor, Pat, and he lives just up the hill from you.
He's been wanting to meet you for years.
He's looked down and laughed upon your broke ass
trying
for
to help you.
40 years. 40? You're not even that old. All right. We got a couple more texts. How many texts do we have left? Because we got to get out of this segment.
Two.
Right, two texts left.
Yeah.
Two texts.
And this next text is going to be a short discussion. I have a feeling.
All right. Hit us with the text.
It says, is this the Krusty Krab? I don't know.
Is that a SpongeBob
so
reference?
I said, sure is. Are you interested in delivery
it.
Or pickup?
Yeah, I'll take it. All right. Then what's next?
Last
text before we get out of here. And by the way, please hit us up. We need bad days. We had our first bad day earlier this week. For the bad day bracket, we're going to find out how bad your day was and how does it stack up with everyone else.
We're going to let Brian lead that segment from now on, too, because I can't lead a segment. I stink.
You weren't good at that.
I'm the worst.
You were trying to...
I made their cool bad day sound stupid and lame.
You were trying to paraphrase a bad day, but that's... You got to read the details, man.
I don't
you
got to
read the details.
It's not my thing. As soon as I was doing it, I was like, I shouldn't be in charge of this.
You shouldn't be.
No.
Okay, so what's the last
text? All right, so our final text, and this is from today, is... We must hear the rap album, Anonymous B.
It's the Brian Moote Show. Will you hear my rap album?
Yes. Unequivocally, yes.
But we got to drum up some like real support.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Like,
one text isn't going to do
it. If somehow, listen, so everyone knows and so that they're not worried about it if you get cold feet about putting it out there. I've saved it in a million spots.
Patrick has it in a, what'd you say? You had it in like a thumb drive in a briefcase buried under the house. You
yeah,
got
that's
it
right.
burned on CDs.
Yeah.
What was our rap group name?
Outrigger Projection.
Oh, geez.
I'll never.
The Outrigger Projection.
You like how I had it on the tip of my tongue, just ready to throw
it. You know
out
what
there?
That comes from?
What is that, Brian? Exactly what is that?
All right, hold on.
It's like explaining a tattoo. Whatever it is, it's stupid.
One, in 2019, as a white dude, that Outrigger, I am not, that is too close to other, that is not, we're not doing that.
Nope. You could say that fast and just blow
it.
Yeah,
nah. You can't like that's not an album name you can yell out to your friends about how much you love the Outrigger Projection. It just sounds like a weird Facebook group. So that was a bad move. Shouldn't have named it that.
Mm-hmm.
Also, probably shouldn't have done any of that. Patrick asked me earlier today if there are any photos of the Outrigger Projection.
Yeah,
and I'm pretty sure there is from the 1998 or 99. Chichokum Arts Festival.
Oh my God.
In which we performed
yes.
four songs.
I remember that. Please find that. Oh, that was those were the days of like baggy clothes and like
oh the Jenko jeans, dude. You could cut them. You cut them off so you couldn't even see your feet. Those things were amazing. I mean, they're not amazing. But well, look, if you guys weigh in on the text line, 310-429-8903, we will, if we get enough votes, I'm going to say we got to get 20. 20 texts saying, we play the album, we play the album.
Yeah, okay, 20.
All right. Perfect. By the way, also, if you guys are, I mean, please do this. I don't want to pandering for this. Because guess what? This show is a rocket ship to nonsense. And there's
greatness.
There's no
rocket
ceiling
ship
for it.
To sex.
If you guys... You're such a moron. Sucks. If you guys could please rate, subscribe, review, whatever, do all that. You know the housekeeping for podcasts. And we're going to keep this thing going. And I'll be in different places. I believe later this week I'll be in Chicago for morning show boot camp.
Chi-town.
Which ought to be one hell of a time. There's no way I won't have awkward stories from that. Because I'm going to be around about 200 morning show people as... I'm reading newspaper store or newspaper. Who the hell reads newspapers? I was walking the street, LA Times. Just these blogs about Brian Moote losing.
Yeah,
his
if you were comparing the morning show boot camp to a party, who are you at the party? Are you someone who got invited? Are you throwing the party? Are you crashing the party? You weren't invited.
I am not crashing any parties. I'm the person who I'm like the Uber driver who's looking for some like you Uber Eats something. And now I got to find somebody in there to like drop it off. And I feel incredibly awkward. I feel awkward like I do in photos with rappers where I look like I'm everybody's dad. So I'll have stories from that. We'll also be potentially in Dallas, Atlanta, maybe New York. We're going to be all over the damn place. But we are making the infrastructure this week so that we can do this show from any damn place in the world.
Anywhere.
Any damn place.
Yep.
Technology.
From under my bed.
We are. Pat will be hiding there.
Might be under my bed.
We are committed to the show. So let's get into this first. We're going to talk about LeBron and Little League Dads here shortly. But let's talk about we did not hit on this, and I feel like such an a-hole because we talked about your colon cancer update, and you are colon cancer free. At least for now.
Yeah, that's right.
They always say for now.
I know. That's the one thing where people are like, oh my God, that's such great news. It's like, yeah, but I mean, it's,
for now.
Like, it's, I don't want to like, and cancer's not one of those things I want to catch me doing a victory lap. Like, if I'm like, right. I got cancer, I crush kids, I'm a cancer killer. And cancer's still there, like, oh, really?
Yo, cancer's one hell of a dick. Well. Yeah, you don't want to do that. That is a thing where you catch yourself saying things that you, in your mind, like, oh, karma. Oh, just, God.
Yeah, I'm not trying to call my shot on this one, necessarily.
So, Patrick did a, it was Climb for a Cure, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Climb for a Cure. You went to a mountain in Colorado, just outside of Denver.
Winter Park, Colorado.
Winter Park.
Yes. Mount Flora.
Sounds sweet. Sounds nice. You left at like 4 in the morning. Yep. I saw the videos you had, and please go to @PatMoote on Instagram to see these.
Yes,
you,
and follow me. Sorry.
He still wants that K.
Yeah.
Do you have the K yet? You have 10,000?
I don't have the K, man. I can't break 9,200. I'm stuck. Please.
What a bummer. Hey, tell you.
I'm offering things like, you know, Bitcoin and sex.
You just whispered that to me. I don't think anyone could hear that.
I looked you right in the eyes.
Speakers, you
looked
creep.
You right in the eyes.
All right. So you climbed. And what? So tell people about the experience, because you told me some things about meeting the folks that you've met, and you're doing a documentary about colon cancer and about the prevalence of colon cancer and about, you know, the insurance, the screening, the colonoscopies. But tell me about some of the moments in which you felt, I don't want to say woke, that sounds so corny, but like awakened or just perspective.
Awoken. When I was awakened, I was awakened.
Okay, so when, tell me one of those.
So there was a couple moments. So the whole weekend was two parts. The first part was in ambassadors training. So they chose 12, this fight colorectal cancer, fight CRC. Chose 12 people to be ambassadors. Most of us are survivors. There was a couple caregivers in the mix.
Which I found out I can be a caregiver for next year.
You can.
I was given all the cares.
Yeah,
man.
Brian gave like care for me. And you know how like when people are like, yeah, you know it's a caregiver when it's a person that you lash out at most when you're down. I was like, oh my God, I lashed out at Brian a bunch.
Did you? Oh yeah, you did. Oh my God, you were such.
I would have meltdowns. I wasn't lashing out at you necessarily. I was just
having meltdowns.
I was just, you know.
Like, I want to slap you one time.
I was like Chernobyl, and you were like those helpless scientists. Just like, we don't know what to do. I don't know. Put dirt on it.
I would also say this, y'all. If you don't know the kind of nausea medications that they give chemo patients, Lord, somebody please make that for hangovers. Yeah. Because this dude fixed my life one day.
Any bachelorette parties, let me know.
Oh, my God.
I'll send you some Zofran.
Guys, they have stuff you put under your tongue, and you immediately are fine. And all these years, I've been just like toughing it out, walking it off, just dealing with my poor choices from the night before, when all I had to do was throw a little tab under my tongue.
Yeah.
I did feel a little bad taking your anti-nausea meds when I had to.
You should have. It was a dick move.
I felt bad.
It's a terrible thing to do.
Felt way better.
Well, that's funny that it's like, yeah, I did feel a little bad stealing from the cancer patient.
But then I didn't feel that bad afterwards.
Yeah, sure.
All right, so tell us more about the experience.
The ambassador training. And there was a moment where I was sitting there and they're kind of going over like all the things that we're going to do in terms of like talking points and initiatives. Sure. And like we're doing a lot of like legislative work and you know, community outreach and stuff like that. So they're kind of telling us what we're going to say and how to spread the message.
Part of Fight CRC's whole thing is not just raising money and stuff, but the awareness part. But that's important because it's not a fear-based.
No.
Like, you're going to die of colon cancer. It's an education thing where it's like, look, if you have some of these symptoms, which you found out are hemorrhoids at an early age.
So many people.
Uncharacteristically young. You need to go in and get checked out. You need to, and for a lot of these doctors, you got to force the issue.
Well, and if you have hemorrhoids, because of the 12 people, I think 10 of us were survivors. Eight of those survivors were all under 40. I think all of them were misdiagnosed as hemorrhoids.
Yeah.
Or IBS or Crohn's or colitis or whatever. But I mean,
and you always thought it was stress, but really it was just cancer.
Mine was hemorrhoids too. But then there was a point where I was like, that's some crazy ass hemorrhoids, man.
Well, there were times where you were like, I'm getting like steroid injections. Like that's one hell of a hemorrhoid when you got to whip out a steroid needle and shoot that sucker.
Shoot it up.
Right. That's not a normal hemorrhoid.
Well, no. And it wasn't even hemorrhoids. It was like, dude, it was great. If you have hemorrhoids, if you've been diagnosed with them, you should insist on getting a colonoscopy because the symptoms are the same, you know, for the most part. Mm-hmm. There are other symptoms with colon cancer as well. But either way, there was like a couple moments where I was sitting there and I was like, this is so surreal. Like, how did I get here?
Yeah.
How am I sitting in this room? Actor guy Pat, who just like does whatever he wants and only thinks about himself and is always like worried about why he's not the coolest and most famous person in the world, all of a sudden is sitting there in this room with cancer survivors as a cancer survivor working on trying to help other people. Like, it was crazy.
Well, and one guy you talked about going on the hike with, the mountain climb for a cure, go check out Fight CRC. He had a chemo pump on him installed in his body.
Yeah, yeah. And had just come off of an actual treatment, but was like getting kind of like a constant chemo blast on his liver while we were there.
So he had it in his liver too?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Good God. I mean, and so we climbed to the top of this first peak of Mount Floor and we got there and it was pretty easy. I mean, people were like, oh man, it's going to be so hard. It's going to be so crazy. I was like, I'm going with cancer patients. It's not going to be the craziest hike in the world. Like, we can't
it's like the first part's like a 5K for something. Sure. Like, you're not trying to like demolish someone's life with a 5K.
So then this wild man who was leading the whole thing was like, yeah, if anybody else wants, there's another peak right over there. There's just a little saddle we got to go down. Let me come up and then we're going to chuck up your hands, no big deal, bros. And we're like, okay, so six of us decide to go with him. It was ridiculous. Insane. It was so ridiculous. We walked down, straight down like 1,000 feet, then back up like 1,200 feet, then back down 1,200 feet, then straight up 1,000. On the way back up, I looked at my buddy, who was the guy who was still in treatment, and he was just like, this might have been a really bad idea. Really, really
he's
bad
like,
idea.
Looked, I, know.
I was like, oh my God, I know, dude. I've been meaning to ask you, like, I've been waiting for you to just fall over and all this, be like, oh my God. Oh.
Pat's like, hey, oh, God. This guy who's got chemo on his liver right now, he thinks this may be a bad idea.
All right, that's it. The dude beat cancer but died on a saddle.
All right, coming up next, because we're going to bump LeBron till tomorrow, tomorrow's show. We ain't talking about Little League dads till tomorrow.
It's fine.
Someone messaged me today talking about colon cancer, you, and our relationship, and me leaving Atlanta to do a morning show in Los Angeles. Having that situation, not pan out, well, I don't know, exactly how I wanted it to. And they put something in perspective, and we're talking about the next, and I want to hear about what people can do next to follow your colon cancer in your fight CRC battle. When I say Brian, you say Mucho Brian.
I'm not going to do that.
That's really not bad doing idea. That. It's a bad idea, man. Hey, that's
not
why
you're do that.
Come on, I know. That's why you got to hit the burner phone, 310-429-8903. I'm going to say it 1,000 times.
I love it. It's working. Just call
us. Well, look, the idea of this show is, yes, you can get it here on Apple Podcasts. You can get it here on radio.com. You can get it here as of today on iHeart, the iHeart app. Because we ain't got no allegiances to nobody.
No, that's right.
I do what I want. And that's what the show is all about. We do what we want. We talk to you. I want, and look, we're in the beginning stages. We're just building this ship. And I want people
building
to
this ship while we're flying it.
Shit.
That's how you go.
I'm just tightening bolts while we're already off the ground, man.
We're just going to, you know what? You better fix it now. We're going to crash right into the ground.
Look, I didn't think about that part of it. But we're flying. We're off the ground. And look, we're a fun time. I got to be honest. We're the most fun you've ever had. Are we? I'm not sure. But
I don't know. I mean, I think we are.
I think we're a barrel of fun. Mom said
sure.
One, mom described our mother, said mom to you like no one knows.
Mom.
She described, our mother described me as a barrel of fun on stage as a comedian. And I believe that stands up.
A barrel of fun.
I think she's being sarcastic.
Yeah, you're sure she's not taking a shot at you?
Oh, like calling me fat?
Well,
like
I don't
he's
know.
A fatty of fun.
And just like a barrel, like, you know, it's like a
look,
bulk. It's like buying fun in bulk. Like if it was like, you know.
He's Costco sized.
Yeah.
Not to make it all about me. And you know what? That's a topic I want to write down. I've got a lot of fun stuff where I want to write down. We've got coming up down the, I don't know what I was talking about.
I love that. That was such a Pat Moote moment right there.
It was. Well, it just like, look, I find myself doing the corny radio stuff and I'm just so done with that. I don't want to tease songs. Guess what's not coming up? Any music. Done with it. Don't care. Ariana Grande, thank you. Next podcast episode. Don't ever care to hear about that stuff again. No, I just keep writing down all the fun stuff we're going to do. We have the passive aggressive Breaking Bad News Doctors.
Oh yeah.
That's going to be a lot of fun.
Breaking Bad.
I told that story today to somebody, the manager of the comedy store. Hello, name drop. And she literally said that's the funniest, like she's mortified and funny at the same time. Like what doctor would just be like, yo, just, I gotta go get a sandwich, dude. Jimmy John's, man. They close soon. You've been to Jimmy John's.
We had the experience. I mean, we already talked about that, but my doctor basically bailed on giving me my results. Made
but
my buddy do
how
it.
Great would it be if he would not give you the, he just didn't want to give you the bad ones. He's like, oh yeah, yeah, just tell him like, look dude, it's over for him.
Yeah,
he's got 90 days left. You know him better than I
doctor's
do.
Doctor's like, hey, actually I just got a phone call, I'll be right back. And then he hits you up on like Facebook Messenger. He's like, you have cancer. It's like in a gif.
You go, hey doc, do I have cancer still? And he just thumbs down the text.
Boink.
He doesn't even say anything. All right, so here's a story that got brought up to me today when I was talking about, look, I've it's been a weird couple weeks for me. When you leave a radio show and you want to do it respectfully, you don't have any bad blood for anybody. You maybe have your opinions. Don't hit the siren on me. I'm good.
I'm so close.
No. Look, it's weird. It's like I'm getting hit with texts now. People saying like, oh my God, are you okay? I'm like, well, this happened 2 weeks ago. And I chose not to bring it to social media and make it sloppy, make it weird, make it messy. I don't want to blast anybody. Business is business. Happens. You know what? You know, and people have texted me today. It's probably for the better. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see when that happens. But what someone brought up today was because they listened to the show, and this podcast show has changed forms. It's been the Moot Points podcast, as a lot of you listened. And if you have listened from back in the day, thank you. If not, maybe we'll rerun some of those episodes because I had a 2-hour interview with my father who went to prison, and I'm proud of him now. We've talked about Pat's cancer. We played one of Pat's farts on this show.
Yeah, that was cool.
He was constipated for 2 weeks. And our nurse friend told him to do yoga to try to get the bowels moving again, right? To loosen up the old pipes, to get the pipes a moving. And in the middle of an Instagram video, he rips out a fart.
Well, you were trying to exploit my constipation.
Well, I was like, hey, Pat, what are you doing?
For views.
Yeah, what's your yoga position? Of course I was.
Yeah, and I had a big old fart bubbling, and so I... Bubbling.
I'm trying to find the video.
It was so rowdy.
I've sent it to you like 1,000 times. We have the audio.
Oh, I have it. I have it 1,000 times.
But here's the funny part. Not funny, because that none of that's funny.
Colon all cancer. Of it's funny. It's all... Well, it can't...
It's funny that you're surviving, but... Someone reminded me today, they go, hey man, if you didn't move back to LA, if you didn't take that job in LA, because a lot of people don't know this, you were in Atlanta with me a lot, but yeah, Atlanta was not your home.
No, no.
You were there to work. You were there working with the Atlanta Hawks, doing unbelievable sketch work with an NBA
team. Yeah, auditioning and doing all that stuff, but I've lived in the same place in LA for 11 years.
Shady Center Studios, where we're at right now,
places
on Beachwood and Gower, like, that's where you've been. For what you say, 15 years now?
No, no, no. But
you've been in this neighborhood for 11 years.
Like 11 years, yeah.
11 years as an actor. It's impressive.
My neighbors love me.
Of course.
They love me. We don't even speak the same languages. We make them up.
They don't care.
No. It's fine. Same people.
It's an amazing place, right? And I think what I got reminded about today was like, look, you guys were making, we were on Patty Poop Watch. Initially on the show. So if you go back and listen to prior
episodes.
Yeah,
you started the show in January. I was diagnosed 3 months later.
Right. So in January, we started just screwing around with the Moot Points podcast. And you hadn't pooped in, what, 2 weeks? 12 days?
Something like that.
So we had this Patty Poop Watch going. Like, and it was like, it was laughable. We were laughing. Ha ha ha. Pat hasn't pooped. He's constipated. Our nurse friend, Taylor Schreck, told us, like, hey, he should do yoga. So we're all sitting here drinking. Ha ha, having a good time. Pat's doing like downward.
Mom
dog.
Had me like doing like gut massage too, to try and like
stuff.
Massage the poop out.
Yeah, it's so gross. All insane. Because everyone just assumed like you were just constipated. And we were making fun of it, and this fart was unbelievable. And
I just didn't think it was cancer.
Right, but that's the point.
Yeah.
So we played that fart on the podcast on morning radio in Los Angeles. Your fart was played. Your downward facing fart was played on. Yeah.
You were like,
Los
what
Angeles
position are you doing?
Radio.
And I would say, upward facing fart, just ripped ass so loud.
And you know what? Los Angeles.
Nailed it.
The most
Nailed
original
it.
Thing that's been on your radio airwaves was my brother farting because of cancer.
Upward facing fart. I mean, come on. That's just well played. That's good
it's
comedy.
Amazing. So, but here's the thing that I was reminded of. And I'm not a big everything happens for a reason guy. I'm a little bit. I don't know, dare I say, pessimistic. Now, I'm very positive.
You're definitely not a Mercury's in retrograde kind of guy.
No, I don't believe you can blame space on anything or your birthday. Just life happens.
Unless you get probed by some aliens.
I feel like in my life I've learned that bad things will happen, good things will happen. They're never connected. Unless that person does the same bad thing to you multiple times. In which case, maybe that's your fault. Maybe you need to learn how to say no to people. Whatever. Bad things can happen to good people, and it doesn't mean you're owed something good. I don't believe in karma. I think people who do believe in karma think there's some sort of galactic scoreboard where they got kicked in the balls 20 times. But, I'm going to win the Powerball. Everything goes wrong. No, man, just live your life. Bad things happen, good things happen. A good thing that I was reminded of that did happen was the fact that if we didn't live here, right? Like, if we didn't... You were back here doing acting stuff. Atlanta had kind of dried up a little bit. We were out of contracts with the Hawks. I got an offer to come back to Los Angeles, which, let's be serious, market number two in the country. Start a brand new morning show. The vision when I started was do something different. Be different. Seacrest is big fancy pants celebrity guy. Big Boys Neighbor. Like, all these big shows, they're all monster celebrities. Why don't you guys be the people's show, right? Get out there. Be nice. Be this, be that. And I'm like, that sounds like something I want to do. But also, like, I want to go back to L.A. Had this. And I have a life in Atlanta. My girlfriend's in Atlanta. My dog's in Atlanta.
A house in Atlanta.
House in Atlanta. And it just felt like the right time. Maybe the show wasn't the right fit, sensibility-wise. But the craziest thing is that had I not been on the radio, maybe we don't mess with that fart on the air. Maybe we don't. Maybe you do go get a colonoscopy. Maybe you don't.
Sure.
But we like shamed you in it. We were like a funny support group to get you to go get your colonoscopy. To then you found out you had stage 3 cancer. We were filming. I was recording audio when you found out you had stage 3 cancer, which was not funny, and we did not put that on the air because it was a real bummer when Dr. Tabib was like, yeah, you're going to have to get a surgically
get surgery.
They can maybe take it through these holes that you already have from your appendix being removed. And so the thing I was reminded of was like, look, man, is you may not believe things happen for a reason, and I don't necessarily believe that. But the crazy thing is that maybe all that stuff doesn't happen the way it's supposed to happen, and maybe you never go check it out. Maybe you go check out your colon. Maybe you start pooping again. And maybe you don't check out your colon for another 6 months. And then it's stage 4. It's too late. You can't.
Yeah. Well, I also have had, because I had a similar thought, and when you teased it, I kind of thought we were thinking the same thing, but for me, the thought that I had about all of this and like you leaving Atlanta, coming back, especially now because you're not on the show anymore, was how happy I am that you're just here.
Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, had you not been here, not that I
couldn't have done it without you, bro.
But seriously, like, you picked me up from chemo a lot. And, like, you dropped me off at chemo a lot.
We went
like,
to Buffalo Wild Wings at
you
the chemo.
You stayed
sometimes.
Over, you know, like.
Well, I stayed over every time you were alone in chemo.
Yeah,
like I can't have you here with your chemo bag strapped to you. That god-awful 48 hours with you have a bag strapped to you. Pumping
so
you.
There was, you know, I did have that, like, kind of, you know, those moments where I was like, even before, you know, where it's like, maybe he's just meant to be here for whatever reason. And then you lost the job. And I was like, oh, well. Still glad he was here.
It's hard. I got to be honest. And don't hit the siren on me because I mean this from the bottom of my heart. It's hard to do something, to take risks. And I believe you always have to. Take risks. Push yourself. Always try to improve. Believe that you're going to be okay. You're going to be fine. Don't be afraid. Don't let fear rule you not making certain choices in your life. But it's hard for me. At times, not to look at this whole situation and not want to just beat the ever-living hell out of a lot of people who made a lot of poor decisions in terms of the business of radio. Was that too serious? You didn't hit the siren on me at all.
No.
No, I mean, serious though, man. It's like, I'm never going to agree with what happened.
No, and by beat the hell, you meant with emotion.
Figuratively. Well, look, I'm not going to go fight somebody. I mean, I've thought about it. No, I'm kidding. I didn't. But I don't have to agree with you. People make decisions. Businesses
people
do.
Make decisions.
I don't have to care about that nonsense. Yeah. Wasn't mine. Now you got to live with it. If it goes poorly, bye. Sorry, you're bad.
Yeah, I have my opinions. I'll just keep it myself.
I'm going to hit the siren on you.
I mean, listen, if you get me going, I have my own siren.
No more sirens.
That's my Trump / amp.
Please hit the studio burner. I'm going to hit it one more time. 310-429-8903. Leave us voicemails. Get drunk. Say something weird. Text Pat weird stuff. Text anything you want. Any opinions you have. I think what I want to say ostensibly is that... Oh, sorry. I still got the music going over here. That's my fault. Is that I don't think things happen for a reason, but when the right thing happened at the right time and you made the right decision, even if the thing that you wanted to have happen where, you know, 10 years from now, I'm still doing that show and who knows what the hell happens. I still am glad what happened happened. It was not meant to be, but it was fortunate that the things late, you know, fell into place like they did. And I believe that the thing, like, I didn't do anything wrong. I just believed in myself. I believed in the opportunities ahead of me. And at every point of the way, people in my life that I care about have always been like the guiding light as to why I'm going to make a decision or I'm not going to make a decision.
So I've always lived my life by, and people, like, when they've asked me for advice about, like, you know, like career stuff and like, oh, Pat, you do, you know, whatever you want. You've always like followed your dreams and blah, blah. So I always tell them like I live my life like kind of on a what if basis. Like what if I didn't?
What if I didn't?
Yeah, what if I didn't do it? What if I didn't? Like I would always wonder what if. Like,
yeah.
You know, I could have gone a safer route than being an actor, not going to college and like trying to follow all these dreams, which, you know, granted, I'm giving people advice about like, you just don't want to wonder what if. And yeah, I'm like, you know, broke and have cancer. Like, I don't know. Like, I don't know. I'm not exactly crushing because I don't know why you ask me for any advice, but
it's
whatever.
Funny when you say it like that because I'm like, yeah, man, you gotta leave. Yo, the what if will kill you.
I know. The one time I was like, I'm all stressed out all the time, just like, I'm living check to check, man.
I was like, I remember one time saying, like, what if I don't marry this girl from England who needs to stay in the country? What's the worst thing that could happen? Oh, geez.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
What if I don't take a job in LA?
Yeah, see, I'm starting to get more in this part of my life. I'm still what if, but it's like, what if I don't? What if I don't do that?
What if I just, like,
maybe let that thing play out?
How much am I going to miss out if I just don't do that? Just no.
What if I just, like, got a real job? What if I just...
What if I do? What if I don't?
What if I just, like, you know, look, dude, what if I just play it safe for a second? Yeah. Look, if it played it safe, none of this would be entertaining.
I know.
And we had so many stories to talk about today. We didn't even get to LeBron and Little League stuff.
I don't eventually. Even care about that. You have a big picture of LeBron right next to you, too. It's like he's looking at you and he looks very pissed off.
I know, but I love LeBron, man.
Like, I have
what
a story.
What if LeBron didn't go to LA? What if he just stayed where he's supposed to? Now, come on, dude. What if he didn't do that?
What if we didn't talk about it?
Well, we don't have any time anyway. We have to go. The show's already running long. So, all right, you guys, hit the studio burner 310-429-8903. Don't be sitting there saying to yourself, what if I called or texted the studio burner?
Now with the 7-Eleven app, use that dollar in your pocket on any size hot beverage, including coffee and lattes, with dairy and non-dairy creamers. Coffee your way for just $1 with your 7-Eleven app, plus tax where applicable, only at participating 7-Eleven locations.